Cheers! We're here in Qingdai today, and I'm here with my lovely colleague Ning, who's a Qingdai local. Tonight we're sampling some of the local cuisine, different foods from the area, along with, of course, the local beer, Qingdai.
Basically, seafood is pretty well known in Qingdao. We got the big blue sea here. So as you can see, scallops, clams, and this is spicy clams, and big shrimps, really huge shrimps.
They are enormous. Yeah.
So, and kebabs. Let's jump in.
Yeah, let's try. I've never seen such a big shrimp in all my life. That is delicious, but it is messy business. The combination is really, really nice because this is super fresh, along with the spicy meats and the really fresh seafood all together. Delicious. But also you're sitting out on this amazing street and there's people all around you having dinner, catching up with friends, and you just feel like a part of this little community.
Yes, this is Qingdao people's nightlife. All these restaurants really open up really till late at night. This is their bar.
And the Qingdai brewery's right over the road, literally there.
After getting a sense of just how loved Qingdao is here and how ingrained it seems to be in the local culture, I wanted to go and check out where it's produced down at the brewery. Qingdao Brewery was actually established by the Germans way back in 1903. Despite opening over 100 years ago and now being a Chinese company, you can still see the European influence in the architecture. The brewery really stands out compared to the surrounding Chinese-style buildings. Since it opened, Qingdao has found its way to over 100 countries, everywhere from the States to Japan, even finding its way to my home in sunny Scotland. Only slightly altering the recipe, Qingdao now uses rice along with hops and grains to make the beer I've been drinking all day. The brewing process has stayed pretty similar, only swapping out machinery to keep up with the sheer quantity now required. While here, I caught up with Dong Fang, curator at Qingdao Beer Museum, to discuss this city's favorite export.
Cheers!
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 Cheers. This is 我们做的德国菜
Oh, really?
这个啤酒呢是一种西方文化，是一种舶来品，德国人当时建厂的植入了非常好的这种基因，中国人融入了或者发挥了我们自身的一些很好的这种传统文化，还有我们的这种管理的优势，还有我们本土的这种优势，那么才把这个啤酒厂把它做大，把它做强，就是为了要 more
So the Shanghai Corporation Organization is coming up. But how do you think trade in Qingdao beer is going with these associated countries?
青岛啤酒借助一带一路的政策和东风啊 那么现在呢，销售到100多个国家和地区。那么和上合组织相关的国家呢，我们的增长速度也非常快，平均增长速度都在
70%以上。It tastes really nice.
Wow. 你酒量非常好。
I've been drinking all day and have loved all the food and company so far. Even though it's late, locals here told me there's one more stop I have to make. We're here at a community bar slash restaurant, as you can say, by all the delicious food in front of me. And this little slate, which is called a one by one. We've got draft, fresh, IPA, and a stout. Earlier I spoke a lot about the lager and the fresh beer, but this shows me Qingdao is really trying to diversify to compete with an international market. Shanghai Corporation Organization, this is a brilliant opportunity to come down to Qingdao, taste the array of beer, taste the beautiful local seafood, and just have a brilliant time. I've been welcomed here, and you will too. Welcome to Qingdao.